And welcome to another exciting video. So let's do quarter note rock. That's what I was always told it was called when I was younger. Quarter note rock. So instead of playing 8 eighth notes on the hi-hat, such as this, which is your good old rock and roll beat, straight eighth note beat. I was playing them evenly there. One and two and all at the same volume. You could choose to do, which would give you the quarter note pulsing through that, right? That's not what I'm really wanting to try and explain, but it kind of thinking about it leads on nicely to what I am going to try to explain. So we did straight eighths, all even, choppy eighths. But then if I pulse the quarter note through those eighth notes, I get this. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. Which is cool, yeah? One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. One, two. But you can play without playing all the in-between eighth notes. So I was accenting the quarter notes, but I was playing all the ands as well. But you can just play the quarter notes, right? So you can go like this. Two, three, one, two, three, four, one, two, three, four, one, two, three, four, one, two. And you can play all the bass drum patterns that you would play out when playing an eighth note straight beat. So that one, one, three, and, but under just quarter notes instead of eighth notes on there. So one, two, three, four, one, two, three, and 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 four. It's quite good fun. If you play it a little bit faster, maybe. I'm just going to go. I've started at 80 there. I'm going to zip on up to 100 to give you the sound of that, which will be like this. One, two, three, four. 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 Just like that. Funky! What I also wanted to explain was, as well as playing straight notes on the bass drums, i.e. straight fill, which is this, as opposed to swingy fill, which if you swung those eighth notes, instead of getting that, you get one and two and three and four and one and two and three. So a straight version of a straight eighth pop beat, with one, three, and on the bass drums, two, four, and the snares is one and two and three and four and one and two and three and four. And if I swung that with the same bass drum pattern, you'd get one and two and three and four and one and two and three and four. And which is cool, right? You might be able to play that's called a shuffle. You might be able to play that, you might not. But that is what I also want to use bass drum wise under our quarter note rock based feel, okay? So if you go back a few steps, you would have heard me playing straight eighths on the bass drum with quarter notes here on the hi-hats. If you actually be playing minims on or half notes on the snares, it doesn't matter about that. You can hear where they go. So what we were doing a minute, the whole idea of this was to try and play quarter note rock, okay? Which we've done. Which is straight, but we also want to play quarter note rock swung with a kind of shuffle feel, but without the t-t-t-t-t-t-t-t. So quarter note rock with a swingy feel sounds like this. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. that's all I'm doing is the quarter notes. One on the hi-hats. Four, one, two, three. Two on the snare. One, two, three, four. One, two. Here comes the bass drum. One, two, three, four. One, two, three. So what I'm going to do now, right, is do one bar of straight quarter note rock and one bar of swung quarter note rock. I'll just do one after the other, alternating them so you can compare the feel of the two, right? Here we go, ready? Two, three, straight. Swung. Straight. Swung. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. Okay, well, we'll do this time, I think, is to do four bars. Two bars of straight, two bars of swung. Incidentally, we're at 100 beats per minute. Yeah, those beats, I'm just thinking of a song that uses its kind of straight feel. A song by Free, a band from the 70s, kind of blues rock band. They did a song called All Right Now, and it kind of has that kind of straight feel. Obviously I was messing with the bass drum part, but that's kind of what, very broadly speaking, goes on in that song. It varies, varies kind of around that sort of main phrasing. And then there's a Bad Company song. I can't think of the title of it, but it has that that kind of shuffle feel. So there's two songs by some crazy, heavily, groovy, inspired rock bands that, you know, you can employ that in those sorts of feels. So, I'm trying to think of the song. Bad Love, Giving, Loving, can't think of the song. It's by Bad Company. I need to look this up. It's bugging me. It's in a grade 4 book, I think. Which I don't seem to have. Oh, how frustrating. Anyway, there's hundreds of songs you can use it for, right? One more. Let me play straight quarter note rock. This time I'll do four bars. Actually, I'll do three bars. I'll do three bars of straight quarter note rock into a fill-in into three bars of swung quarter note rock. Into a filling, and the fillings will be kind of in that feel, okay, in a similar feel. So right, here we go. We'll stay at 100, okay. Three bars time into a filling, three bars time into a filling. Time just means the groove. Here we go, keeping it steady. So straight. Thank you. so forth. You can play obviously faster. Obviously you can play faster, quite a lot faster than that, and still keep the feel of those bass drum parts. But I wouldn't probably, if you're trying to learn that from scratch, I'd probably start it pretty slow. If you really want to make it totally easy for yourself, you could just build it up in layers. So you could just literally go 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. I like to do hats, bass drum, then snare, but you might want to go hats, snare, then bass drum. Similarly, if I do the same sort of thing for the swung one, 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, other videos. But that's an important thing to be able to do. Play that quarter note. There's lots of things that use that. Sometimes you might be playing like a part of a song using eighth notes, going into another part of a song, or you just might switch up to quarter notes only. Quite often, not that often, can be that you playing straight eighths on there, do a filling into a chorus, and you might change just the quarter notes on the right cymbal, but quite often I've done it myself, where I play a quarter note pulse on the bell of the ride, okay? You can play quarter notes on the crash cymbal as well. I wouldn't tend to play quarter notes on the edge of the ride, but maybe on another crash cymbal. Gets a nice washy, kind of lush sort of sound. Right, anyway, thank you very much. Good night. I hope you enjoyed it.